my house?
Buddy, I'm home from Navy SEALs training. Hey, Han, what's with all the mess?
Nothing, dear. Just give me a second. I'm slipping into something more comfortable.
Damn, baby. Someone got hungry.
Well, that's all for you, dear. Dig in.
What the fuck happened last night?
I brought you flowers and AA batteries. Movie night.
Wait a minute. I don't have a wife. Get the fuck over here, boy!
Two menus, please. One for me, and one for my friend here.
Konnichiwa, and welcome to Super Sushi Sunrise. Can I start you off with something to drink?
I'm going to go for the prime rib roll, cooked excellent. Ah, well done. And my friend here is going to go...
Dude, there's no one sitting here.
Yes, there is!
Who is sitting in that chair?
My friend!
That chair is empty. You're crazy.
Delusional.
You're the delusional one. Can a man and another man not share a meal?
It's okay if you thought I was waving at you. It happens literally all the time.
Oh, sorry. Am I in an invisible box? Can you guys hear me?
I was waving at my friend!
All right, look, you gotta go. All right, you and your friend, out, now.
There it is, you see? Here we go! Is anybody recording this? Ha! I guess we'll just take our business elsewhere. Come on, let's get out of here. You can't see it, but he's flipping you off too.
I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't have lashed out. Yeah. Yeah, they were jealous.
They just don't see you like I see you.
Nobody does. I guess that's what makes it special though, huh?
Just tuning in, then you may have not heard about the raging fire affecting multiple family homes in Freeville.
City officials estimate that more than 20 townhouse properties are caught in the flames, and JBS7 is live on the scene, talking to those whose lives have changed forever.
That's right, Doug. Let's now turn to our colleague Mark, who is there in Freeville with the latest.
Hey, thanks, guys. Yeah, look. This is an incredible tragedy taking place right now. There's no other way to say it. The fire rages on, and it just doesn't seem like it's stopping anytime soon.
Mark, how are these families processing this terrible event?
That's a great question, Chelsea. I met with a father who had just lost his entire property and family in the flames. He said that I was a very stand-up guy, and that I have a bright future for myself in this industry. Just another conversation that made me feel really good about myself. There really is hope in this world, after all.
Yeah, that's great, Mark, but our viewers really want to know more about how the families themselves are dealing with this tragedy.
Line?
Young boy, dead family?
Right. Well, I also met with a young boy who had just lost everything in the flames. All he has ever known is now gone forever.
That is just awful, Mark.
He said that his favorite toy cars had been lost. So I showed him pictures of my son's collection, and he said that he's very jealous and that my son and I were very cool.
Okay, Mark, I'm gonna stop you right there.
Okay.
Is there any last story? You know, one more about the actual families themselves before we have to cut away?
Yes, Chelsea, there is, actually. I met with a grieving woman who had just lost her fiancé in the flames. She said that I was very handsome, and I actually have her number right here.
We want to apologize to our viewers for our colleague Mark. No one should be making this terrible tragedy about themselves.
We are so, so sorry. But we do have another reporter on the scene who is directly interviewing the families right now. Let's cut over to our own Samantha Farmsworth, reporting live in Freeville.
I mean, what can I say? I'm absolutely devastated. I lost everything that I have in the fire. But there's this really cool guy there. And I think his name was Mark, and he was just awesome. And he just rocked so hard. And I mean, that makes me feel like the fire is temporary, you know? But Mark's forever.
Samantha, is there anyone else with you hoping to share their story?
Yes, actually, we have a man here who just narrowly escaped the flames thanks to our first responders.
I'm on TV.
Yes, you're on TV. Now, can you tell us a little bit about what happened?
Hi, Gary. I told you I'd make it on TV.
Sir, the fire's being contained. You're safe.
He's been chasing me for 24 hours. I can't keep running. If there's anyone out there who can help me, please, please.
Tell me your shit.
Oh, God!
You're pretty.
Tragic. Just tragic.
Truly. And now, one question remains on our mind. What started this catastrophe?
Shota.
All right. Everyone can stop freaking out.
The dip is here.
Hey, you made it.
Whoa, no peeking.
Lords and ladies, I have thy dip. Lexi, I got you black olives on top. Parker, sprinkled paprika. Logan, basil, obviously.
Oh, perfect. Just put it next to Brad's dip.
Brad's dip.
Brad? Lexi's boyfriend? Yeah, he brought dip too.
Hey, man, I'm sorry. I don't know you were on dip, but look, it looks really good, and I gotta try it.
Brad, huh?
What? What's wrong with Brad?
What? I didn't even see it.
Okay.
Keep going.
So?
Okay. It's just, why would anybody need a piece of shit like Brad?
What are you talking about?
What does Brad know about Super Bowl spreads? What does he think? This is some kind of Ruffles league?
Tell me this isn't about the dip. Why are you like this?
You know, you've always been so selfish. Everyone here is having a good time, and all you can worry about is your stupid dip. If you'd just gone and seen a therapist, like we said, then maybe you'd just be a little bit happier to be here.
Can I talk to you for a second?
What? What's going on?
Brad's got it going on. I mean, Brad's what's going on.
What? I like Brad.
Is this your card?
Yeah, this is my card.
I bring the dip, not Brad. Brad can go fuck himself.
Hey.
Save it for the horses, Sally. I get one day out of the year where I can be somebody. Super Bowl Sunday. My day. My dip. And that two-timing son of a gun is ruining my day. This isn't fun, Sally. I'm not having fun.
Listen, Lexi's been through enough. She had to break it off with that Navy SEAL guy and Brad. Who cares that he brought dip? The more the merrier. Listen, Molly.
Let go of me. Touchdown! Is brought to you by
Progressive. One thing no one would challenge. It's a Progressive commercial, Walter.
Killer dip, Brad. What's the secret?
Hey, man, I didn't even make it. I got it from the store.
Store-bought.
Store-bought!
Wally, can you calm down? It's just a game.
Well, this is just a game to you.
It's literally football.
It's not about the game! It was never about the game. It's about principle.
Enough! If you keep this up, I'll put you on plates and cups, you inconsiderate asshole.
Why don't you put Big Dick on plates and cups? He looks up for it. Yo, why don't I take out the trash? Come in and out. You won't even notice I'm here.
Leave, Walter.
But...
cream cheese?
What, is Stop and Shop shitting this too?
Get out, Walter!
Hey, Walter. Don't worry about it. We all gotta dip sometimes. Right?
Chelsea, I wrote your name in cursive. See?
Okay.
I have like a fire pit, which is nice in my backyard. I have a backyard. It's not an apartment.
Okay.
I don't know. Bye. See you tomorrow or sometime.